I'm gonna say, yeah.
Violator Vlog, we in here. Super Saiyan John Fee, come on.
You know, Child's Play. We gonna check it out. Honestly, my opinion, I don't think it's gonna be good.
I'm scared.
That's crazy as hell. That's crazy as hell.
I think it's gonna be
Audrey
wax
Plaza sauce. Gonna do her thing. Dude from Atlanta gonna do his thing. You think it's gonna be? You really think it's gonna be bad?
I think it's gonna be wax sauce.
Why?
Because most scary movie remakes is bad.
Yeah, if you count the mid 2000s, maybe.
Nah, bro.
Mid 2000s. Nah.
I say the best one that was a good remake would be Carrie.
About it.
No,
it was good.
This is made by it.
Okay.
Yo, the producers, and I was just about to say that. See, it came out of nowhere. Nobody expected it to do the numbers it did.
I don't think
Child's Play about to put some crazy numbers up, but I do think they're going to put a solid $250 million.
I don't see it.
Solid $250 million. That's not bad.
I don't see it.
Rotten Tomatoes gave it a 67 so far, so.
That's just passing.
I'm hearing it might be a Child's Play too, actually. So
it's just passing.
We're going to see what O'Ryan got. We're going to see. You already know Violators. We in here.
July 5th. That's the next one coming out. We probably won't do a vlog episode, but this is going to be. I obviously think it's going to be one of the most highly anticipated.
I'm getting my tickets next week. I think the tickets came out already, but I'm going to see the day of. Tassio, we in there. You already know, baby. That's my Marvel movie man right there.
Hold on. Let's get over here.
What are you talking about?
You know, The Lion King. My favorite movie. You heard me?
Now, okay, I get it. Lion King gonna do a billion. What's gonna do?
Oh, hell yeah.
Lion King. Global phenomenon.
Best Disney movie ever.
No, it's not. Toy Story.
Best Disney movie ever.
Toy Story 4 is killing it right now. This is what happens when you go to the movies as much as us. This is what happens. You get free drinks and free popcorns.
Realistic, because like that's just how technology is and shit.
It's a cautionary tale of AI. That's what I've been saying. I told you would like the movie. Violators, he liked the movie.
I lived through it. I conquered my fear.
The thing is, for a Chucky fan that I am, it was a lot more entertaining than the original movie. The original, that's what set the tone. Oh, definitely. You know, but this right here, this was a modern day Chucky movie. It was a technology movie. Like, but once again, you liked the movie.
I enjoyed it.
Ladies, you like the movie?
No.
You didn't like it? I like it.
Mixed reviews.
She doesn't like anything. Violators, and we out. What up, everybody? Top to top, it's your boy Jay, Super Saiyan Jaffe.
Cool guy JD on IG.
Seymour Cake, the original. What's up, y'all? How y'all doing?
Jimmy Thump, the originaler.
Mo Rants.
Hey. I don't got no good Mo Rants lately.
No rant today?
Nah, I don't got no good ones. I just got
to
get...
I was trying to swag you up.
Nah, I gotta get back in my hefty. Like...
Coming right from work, so you burnt out.
I mean, you got your shirt open.
I'm trying to let you know some GD5 and shit.
So yeah, it's cool.
He definitely look like you sell work in Jamaica.
I fucked with the
whole
fit.
Yeah,
it's
hot
ass. I had to come with the
cutoff. Julius is freaking crazy.
That was
fun.
It's kind of fun. It's toasty.
Call me Ox.
The plug.
Ayo, but Violators.
Hold on. Lulu off of Pay the Fool.
Pay the Fool.
He look like Lulu?
That's what it looked like. His name should be Lulu.
Chef out though.
Nah.
Call me Mom Lulu.
Lulu Black.
Yeah, your complexion.
I'm ready. Call me Lulu from
that one. Change
Lulu
my
Black.
Name in the chat to Lulu.
You want Lulu?
Yes, I'm
Lulu.
Lulu. I'm Lulu.
Not Teabag, but Lulu.
Nah, Lulu.
Teabag, Lulu Black.
Nah, I'm Lulu. Lulu Black.
That's got a good ring.
Lulu Black.
All right, continue.
Nah, Lulu Black. Lulu Black is raw. Lulu Black.
It's raw. Violators. So if you didn't already peep it, which you probably did because you're sitting right here now, we got Violet Balls going off.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Start of phase 3.
I like how you putting that.
Juju Feige.
I'm feeling that. Hey, for the reason we had the Violator Vlogs, first off, Child's Play.
Yeah.
James.
Yo.
The fact that, you know, Chucky traumatized you growing up as a kid.
It was bad.
How was the movie? I'm gonna let you take it first. How was the movie?
I really like, I got home from that movie and I was like, I want to watch it again. Mm-hmm. And I never want to watch movies again.
He said that.
I don't think it was that good.
He said that.
But it was, I don't know.
It was better than Bad Boys 2.
It was so much fun for me. I don't know why. It was so fun.
It was definitely fun.
It was a fun movie.
It was definitely fun. Like it was.
What's your take?
I wouldn't look at it as a scary movie.
No, it wasn't scary at all.
It wasn't scary at all. I just think, like, you know what I mean? So, just an innocent mind that just want to kill him. Just want to kill somebody real quick. You know what I mean? Like, oh, killing's cool, huh?
That's ass.
Yo, I'm going to say this. I'm going to say this about Child's Play. Like I said, I am an avid fan of Chucky and the Child's Play series. It got whack after Seed of Chucky. But they came back with Colt and Curse. The thing, what I'm taking away from the movie is...
I like the originality.
I did like the originality, but I didn't like how in the beginning of the movie, I didn't like how glitchy he was. It didn't seem authentic. Like how is this glitchy as...
Tisha Campbell
looking
down. Yo, I'm trying to tell you, it looks like Tisha Campbell the whole thing.
Spoiler alert, we're getting into some spoilers. If you haven't seen the movie, first off, go check it out. Pause this show right here. Come back to us. But we get into some spoiler territory. Listen, the kills were original. How he killed the perverted janitor. That was original.
That was cool.
I like that.
The guard and auger one. They ripped the dude's face off.
I'll put him on a
pumpkin.
Like, not a pumpkin, a watermelon?
That felt pretty age throwback classic.
Like, but you know what the thing is, you know, from a guy like me who works with ladders all day, that's some scary shit. Like, that make me feel like, you know what I mean? If I fall off a ladder, like, I'm not landing on my feet. I'm going to have to take that L.
I'm a motherfucker that I don't work on ladders. That's just scary, bro. Like, nah. But honestly, bro, dude had it coming. Like, God, yo, I didn't see that. Dude had a family.
That was a curveball.
That's how they get every man with a family, though.
Man.
He was a bitch.
Nah, it was...
Bro, I would've whooped his ass.
It was some old...
If I was a little boy, I would've whooped his ass. I don't care if I gotta take that L.
Andy, he ain't...
You about to catch this fade.
Andy Barkley didn't have that in his heart.
I'm sorry. Even if I gotta beat your ass while you sleeping on the couch, like...
You gonna take that L?
Yo, I swear I would get a big-ass tube sock.
Think a
10-year-old fill it up with batteries and beat the shit out of him while he sleep.
Think a 10-year-old you.
I'm thinking of a 10-year-old me. 10-year-old me was a mastermind. Yeah, I don't care.
I knew, dude. 10-year-old you?
Yes. I would do it. I would do it. Me, I would call you over and we would jump this. Bro, we wouldn't have jumped him?
Yeah, I would have had you.
Okay, we'd have jumped that fool. Come on, now.
It has been nice. They've been well.
Exactly.
Wait. So, let's bring it back to this.
It all started with a bitch slap.
Let's bring it back to this.
Give it to me.
Mark Hamill.
Mm-hmm.
Good job.
Great job. Again. Great job.
After the perverted janitor gave him the new battery and made him sweeter, swagged him out more, that's when I really fell into the character. I didn't like Chuck. I didn't like the glitchiness. Like, he's talking and his voice is cutting out and he's shorting out. I didn't like that.
Mark Hamill is by far one of the greatest voice actors ever.
He's the greatest.
Who is Mark Hamill?
Luke Skywalker.
That's an iconic role, but voice of Joker, Batman animated series.
I've seen a couple.
Have you played
episodes.
Any of the Injustice games?
Can you pull up his voice list?
Yo, I just like Mortal Kombat. I don't play Injustice.
Dude, Injustice was better than Mortal Kombat. That's
sweet. That's sweet.
I got both, dude. I know. I'm saying, how's you my friend?
Maybe I never gave Injustice a chance. That's what it is.
That's your problem. You don't give shit a chance.
Damn.
That's your problem.
Julie's on shit.
What you mean on shit? I pass out L's all day.
I
pass out L's all day. Julie, like it's...
Julius wanted to share that one time because this was acting...
Pass out L's all day like it's... it's 420, my nigga.
That was tight. That was tight. That was tight.
Serious. Without trying to get too far off topic, the movie. Okay, so it's a 61 on Rotten Tomatoes now. So my takeaway from it, the movie 61 on Rotten Tomatoes. So it's not fresh. So it's certified
not
fresh.
That bad.
The thing about it was the pacing was a little off. I didn't like the character development. The plot was all right. The acting, Audrey Plaza's acting was great. I'll give Audrey that. And
character development.
The character development.
I really like the character development of Chucky.
I like Chucky's character development.
Mark Hammond.
Mark Hammond.
Hamill.
Oh,
all right.
I didn't like the glitchy aspect of it. Like it's
but you got if it, it's it it's, like it's technology, man.
Oh, him.
It didn't seem like it should be a,
he oh,
should be
a he wrong. Though. Yeah, he's wrong.
That's what we've been telling you.
Right.
I'm thinking that, about the old
that,
Luke.
That ain't nothing else.
No, he's the original Luke Skywalker.
He wrong. He's wrong.
And he was the old Luke Skywalker.
He's both Luke. He's, oh, he's the Luke Skywalker. He's
Luke Skywalker.
They didn't change his character. The actor that plays the character.
Yeah. Oh, no, he's
but
wrong.
But nah, okay. I mean, when I say character development, I'm talking
he's just ugly as shit, though.
I'm talking more so, I guess, the kids.
They're kids.
The humans in the episode.
You could only do so much with child acting. Child acting isn't like how it was back in the day.
They were good, though. They were good. They weren't it level good, but they were good. I will say that. But Chucky, I did not like the glitchy aspect of it. It threw me off. It threw me off too much. But to each his own, I thought the movie was good. If we rate it out of 10, I'm gonna give it a
8.
I'm gonna give it a 6.9.
Wow.
I'm gonna give it a 6.9 out of 10.
Wow, that's nuts.
Yeah, I'm a 7.
I'm gonna go with 7.
Yeah. It was fun. Like I said, I watched it again because literally I had fun. I
can't
fun
wait till
it
to come to stars.
It was a fun movie. it was a fun movie. It was.
You know how good. You know how bad it. I mean, you know how shitty a movie is.
Wow.
How quick it comes to stars. The time frame to come to stars. If that shit come to stars within the month, no, it was terrible.
If it go to DVD in a month,
you know it was bad.
That's what Dark Phoenix is about to do.
Yeah. Right.
They pulling that off.
Oh yeah, Dark Phoenix.
They pulling that out of.
Oh. Did y'all see Dark Phoenix?
I did it. It was. I'm not.
I wasn't spending my money on that.
Nah, yeah, I'm not really into it. Right. But yo, I will ask y'all real quick. Nah, the movie did horrible. It's like a 20% on Rotten Tomatoes. I don't even think they made on the back end their budget. Like,
oh, really?
They told the story just all wrong. Like they told the story that they already told.
So Sophie Turner said they was changing the scripts on set like every other day. They were changing the script. If you got a movie like that, it's not gonna work. It's not supposed to. But real quick, before we end off Chucky and bring in our guy Flex God, how y'all feel about the end of the movie? What was your interpretation on the end of the movie?
You know what?
It's definitely room for a sequel.
It's definitely room for a sequel.
Oh, there's always room for a sequel with Chucky.
Definitely room for a sequel.
How many sequels can we get, though? Like, I'm tired of
a trilogy.
It's a reboot. Bro.
A trilogy.
It's a reboot.
Just a strict trilogy.
But before we get off the movie, the thing I liked about it the most is that it's like it was realistic because like with the Alexa, with you know him Chucky being able to control everything, the friggin' Uber, all from the same place.
Yeah,
like
good point. Nah, that Caslin car. I don't give a damn if it is a. I ain't getting no Caslin.
But you gotta think, man. You know what I mean? They coming out. You never know.
Bro, they coming out with too much.
That I'm not driving. No, I'm not getting.
Have you seen some of these Teslas, man?
Nah,
bro,
I don't
these
care.
These Teslas drives for you, so you know. No, so you're not gonna drive a Tesla when we get up. You're not gonna drive a Tesla. You're not copying a Tesla.
No, I would. No.
You're not gonna drive a self-driving Tesla.
No, I'm not driving a self-driving nothing. Nothing.
Okay.
Not at nah, hell. No.
Don't get in my car. Don't get in our car because we're gonna self-driving Teslas.
I'm not. Then I'm. A, that's cool. I got my
self-driving Teslas.
I'm not getting no self-driving.
I'm getting. I'm giving everybody self-driving.
You getting a self-driving something?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd do it.
If I got money for self-driving, whatever, I'm rolling up while it's driving.
You know what?
I feel bad for
you. Do you know? Did you honestly know there's really self-driving cars right now?
Yeah.
Cruise control.
I'm not sitting in it.
You don't like cruise control.
I'm not sitting in nothing that I can't control.
Hold on, bro. You don't even like driving on cruise control.
I'm not. I've never been on cruise. I'm not going to even say that. I don't even know. I've heard of it, but what the hell is cruise control?
You never had cruise control in a V. Ever.
No.
All right.
What is it?
What it is. So you put the car in a certain setting, let's say it's about 75 miles an hour.
Okay. Locks your speed limit. Yeah. So you don't have to put your foot on the gas.
Just sit there like this the whole time. Like literally, are we cool and sitting like this? Just drive like this.
If I'm controlling where I'm going and I'm braking, I'll do that. That's
not
different.
Even doing that.
I'll do that.
So, but you're doing with the self-driving car though.
I don't know if you understand. I'm not letting nothing that's not there drive me anywhere. I don't give a damn who it is, what it is, who it manufactured it.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not getting behind the wheels. Oh, the passenger seat.
Elon Musk, we're really sorry. I still love Tesla.
Hmm. Like Tesla.
Hey, I'll be the lone wolf.
Oh, what do you guys think of Chucky the series?
Comes out next year. I'm not into
it. By the original writers.
Don Mancini, I'm not into it.
Take care of yourself. Have a blessed day.
Here's the thing. these are the same guys that gave us Cult of Chucky two years ago. That was a really good movie. Cult of Chucky surprisingly was great.
Yeah.
But how? What can you tell? It's too much story to tell. Well, I'm sorry. It's not enough story to tell. Child's Play the series. I'm not into it.
Yeah.
I'm not into it. They
Rick and Morty it though. You get what I'm saying?
Make it sci-fi? Are you gonna go from horror to sci-fi?
Cool.
I don't like that. That's kind of what Chucky. Happy Death Day did, and I didn't like how they did that.
Miss me on it.
Happy Death Day.
Yeah. I'm not really that Child's Play series, two thumbs down. I mean, I watched the pilot, but two thumbs down. But before I end off on Chucky, I will say 6.9 rating. It was a solid movie. The kills were very creative. Audrey Plaza, I didn't understand if she was trying to be like a friend. Like, she was a young mom trying to be the cool friend mom.
Abby.
But Violators, like I said, check out Child's Play. Form your own opinions on it.
Tell us in the comments.
If you think it's going to be a sequel. At the end of the movie, his eyes did glitch out red a little bit, which tells me the Chucky that they fought wasn't really that Chucky. It was another Chucky he was controlling. But you never know. We'll see how they tie that in Child's Play 2. All right, but on the back end of the show, we got my guy Flex God on. Let's get it. All right, we back at it with my man Flex God and Wiz. Yeah. You already know.
Flex.
Mm-hmm. Yo, we listened to the mixtape.
Appreciate you.
Shit is Comfort. I want to start with Comfort. Where'd you get the inspiration from Comfort? That shit go hard.
Yo, to be honest with you, I was just scrolling through beats one day in like November, October maybe. And I was sitting at break, and I wasn't even going to pick the beat, you know. But I was scrolling through it, and there was this one pretty girl. And, you know, she was on my break, and she was working with me. And so, like, I'm just, like, scrolling through this beat. She was like, yo, that one's hard. And I was like, really? You like that one? And so, boom, I go to write to it. And it's the weekend. It's, like, Friday. I go to write to it. By Monday, I got that shit done. So I'm about to show her on break. Lo and behold, she's fired. So.
Damn.
Oh, damn. So you never even got to rap with her.
Damn, never even got to see her again. Yeah. I was like, damn. Yeah.
Anything happened for a reason.
Yo, but listen, we got Comfort out of that shit. So.
That's my favorite track on the joint.
I appreciate that, man.
Yeah, so where does, like, your little, I'm saying, like, you got musical inspirations, like, where your inspiration come from?
Definitely X.
Yo, you look like X. It's all good.
You think so? Yeah. Appreciate you.
I hear the X in your music. I thought X too.
I definitely hear the X in your music.
Yo, because like, yo, the way that X makes music, or made music, I suppose.
Listen, please.
Yes, absolutely, man. But like, it's like, yo, the way that he made music was just super poetic, and just super like, yo, you could get anything out of each line, like it depending on your perspective of it. So I was like, how do you make music so vague? But yet so relatable.
Mm-hmm.
I used to think X was trash.
Really?
Yeah, but you can continue.
Oh, shit.
Jesus.
Yeah, it was a lot.
So. That hit me.
Now, you know what, though? The thing about X, I will say, what I liked about X, when he first came out, especially the Look At Me Now, whatever,
I feel like
he couldn't give you the real X then. He needed to open your ears. Yes. He needed to give you that ratchet, the banging beats.
Yep.
He needed to let you know, all right, this is what I could do. But... Now that I got your attention,
this is my style.
I'll show you what it is.
Right.
That's what I like. I like this.
I like the whole switch up, like the whole like the evolution thing.
Right.
Like that was that like how apparent it is dope. Like through like the different hair colors, like just like those three hair colors.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, yo, that's like a dope because it's like, yo, in like with like the blonde joint, dude was just super wild. With the Gray Joint, I don't even know like what albums came with it, but I assume he was super calm with that shit. I assume it was like fucking 17 or some shit. Yeah,
that's when he cut the eyebrows. Or,
that was with the 17 joint, right?
Yeah.
And then boom, then we get the blue hair with the fucking question mark and shit. And then unfortunately, he passes away.
Mm.
But it's like, yo, like for where he could have went, it's like I've made it my purpose to be like, yo, like I fuck with music like that and Trippie Redd and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like there's something missing with it that is just. That can bring it down to everybody.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? That can bring it down to everybody. Everybody can grab something out of it. Everybody can be like, yo, this is some shit that I fuck with.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I got fucking grandmas turning up at my fucking shows.
Mm-hmm.
I'd be like, yo, yes. Like, I got 12-year-olds. Yeah. I'd be like, yes.
Hell yeah.
Now, the sweet thing about it is when I met Flex and everything, you know, he did shows with the Roadie Geese. He know Hefe.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, when
you know, it was telling him about everybody who's been on here.
Hefe is on my mixtape dropping in November.
See?
Facts.
What's the name of that Hefe? Got a name for you?
Not yet.
Not yet?
I don't have a name for the mixtape yet, but I have a lot of,
down.
I have a lot of underrated artists or local artists and a lot of people on my music.
Hell yeah.
You think Hefe charged her a small bag?
Hefe didn't charge me anything.
Nah, that's
I'm
love.
That sweet.
That, yeah.
That's
I'm
love.
That sweet.
Yeah,
I'm
that sweet. Hefe is
I'm
my
that
guy.
Sweet, yeah.
Hefe is my guy. He's
Hefe is a very inspirational person, especially to work with in the studio.
Yo, I've told Hefe many times, like, just like I've never like met Hefe face to face. I've met him once face to face, and that's like how we instantly clicked.
Yeah.
But like, yo, bro, every time he's doing some shit, it's like, yo, I'd hit him up in his DMs. I'd be like, yo, bro, I see you. Like, if it had not been for Hefe, like, I don't think I'd be going as hard. Because it's like, yo, Hefe's showing me what's, like, possible.
Yeah.
Like, in terms of getting out the city, making those connections, and doing these shows. Like, he's the reason that I set my goals on going to Austin, which I just came back.
You ain't lying. We talked about that. Hefe works, bro.
Like, yo, like, real shit.
I just saw him the other day. Me and him was talking. That man worked. That's my guy.
Shout out to Boss Up.
Yes.
You got something with Thugger.
Yeah, I think I forget the name of it, but I heard
it. We gotta get. I honestly say, I like just how we did the draft episode. Like
that's
I say,
it's
we
so
get
was.
Like, you know, Rodegees. Well, even if not everybody, you know what I mean. Get
not everybody. Sure. Violators. I'm telling you, we got some cooked up. All of our guests that we've had, including.
Did we just announce the Violator Music Festival?
We getting it?
That we did.
I would definitely think about a Violator Madden tournament.
But Violators, we gonna swag something out. We're gonna have everybody on at once. We gonna make it happen. Stay tuned for that.
Nah,
but
definitely.
While we got y'all on the panel, this is the thing we do. Once a month we play
Hold
a game.
On. Before we get in the game, let's crack down on this because I still wanna talk about this album.
Oh no, bro. No. I got that. We not done talking on that.
Oh.
We not done.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay,
all right. So we gonna get it popping. So you came in with the category. I'll let you do the honors of it. We playing the game. 1 month ago, we do it once a month. You know, get our debative. I don't even think that's a word.
No, you can just.
It sounds good.
Debative.
Great. I'll take that.
That's what I'm saying.
Get our debate.
Yep.
And we go at each other, and right, wrong, or different, we're gonna go at each other. Give it to me.
1 month ago, best premiere album.
Mm-hmm.
First album. First album. So I'm gonna throw mine out there. Everybody know my favorite artist is Hov.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna throw Reasonable Doubt out there.
Mm-hmm.
Reasonable Doubt.
Okay, now Hov is definitely one of my favorite rappers too. Now I love 50 Cent, he's not one of my favorite rappers, but You Cannot Sleep. Top 5 Dead or Alive, Get Rich or Die Trying, the album, not the soundtrack. One of the greatest albums of all time.
Okay.
Get Rich or Die Trying.
Boom.
Greatest album of all time.
Yeah, it's wonderful. Yeah.
Do what you're trying. That's what we were talking about. I was like, I'm sure.
That's the book.
No. And you don't think that's
No, I respect it. I respect it. It's top 10, though. But, you know, I'm like Nipsey. Nip is victory. Like, I'm not even saying because Nip dead, but.
Definitely.
You and Nip had before.
It was too much.
Definitely.
It was way too
much.
All right, Flash God, what you
think? Yo, I'm going to say. Top 5 Dead or Alive. I'm going to say YNW Melly's, I forgot the name of that shit, but that joint. That yep. we
that's
all
why can, that one
yo, this is...
Go.
What's the name of that shit?
Hold up.
You ain't gotta play it. We heard it.
I ain't playing it. We all shine. We all shine.
That's your choice.
That's my choice. That's what I'm gonna go with.
That's great. That is great. Well, this is hard.
First
album. It's really hard.
Gotta be the first.
Well, yeah, but you guys already named pretty much half of the best ones.
Oh, no, come on. We still got more.
It's some heat.
There is some heat. But, like I said, you guys probably named everybody I would name. I would go with
Dropout.
Illmatic.
Bro, so many artists, like...
It's so many artists in music. I cannot...
Like, y'all youngest, so y'all can choose Lil Juice WRLD if y'all want to.
Juice WRLD's first album was
Juice
fire.
Juice WRLD and Future joint, that shit raw, so... Like,
I give you Future. Yeah. I give you that.
All right, so... We got Reasonable Doubt, Get Rich or Die Trying, Victory Lap. What was
We All Rise.
We All Rise. And you said Future?
So hard.
This is fine.
Like, the pressure on.
Yeah, because it's so much great music that's coming out. But I am also a J. Cole fan. Ooh. I am very hard when it comes to J. Cole. So all of his albums to me,
I feel like that's are number one. I feel like that's safe.
That's not a safe. Because I'm going to throw this out right there.
All
right,
go ahead.
Damn. Friday Night Lights was better than J. Cole's first album. My opinion.
No, you're right.
No, Friday Night Lights was better.
It was. Friday Night Lights was that joint.
What was the song? Okay. Cold World? What was it?
No.
His debut was the one joint when he was on the cover like a fake ass singer and shit.
The Come Up.
Yeah. No, not The Come Up. The Come Up was a mixtape. No, it wasn't The Come Up?
Come Up was an album.
No. He had to warm up, then he had to come up.
I wasn't on J. Cole.
Then he had Friday Night Lights.
I couldn't tell you.
And then,
after Friday Night Lights and on, that's when I was on J. Cole.
Mm. I'm gonna have to go to what's the name?
I didn't really hop on the J. Cole wave until Forest Hills Drive.
That shit was
horrible. A lot of people did though. Because
that shit was fire.
Huh?
Horrible.
Forest, come on, bro.
Horrible. Four Guys Only was horrible.
Yeah. It's a personal album.
What's the album with Cold World?
Cold World.
Wait, what's Cold World?
Cold World.
What about it? What about Cold World?
That's his debut
album. That's what I said, but I got a strong no.
YG had a really good album.
YG?
Yeah.
YG's first album was pretty fire.
It was pretty great.
Which one?
For Real.
That shit was ass.
It was not. It definitely wasn't.
I'm not hating. That sounds like a lot of hate. It's not hate. YG shit don't pop like that.
You Jai is like soft.
Okay.
YG shit
doesn't
pop like
that. See, I think, you know what it is? I think, okay, so you're 20, right?
Yeah.
20?
Mm-hmm.
I think... He's the youngest one for 20 years. So now we got some young ones in here, and y'all generational music. Wow. Now everything's ass now, all of a sudden.
No, it's not ass. I just don't think YG first album so was raw.
I mean, everything was raw.
Everything else that was raw.
See, I'm not.
YG's first album was still Brazy, right?
His first album, Dangerous, was it?
No.
Nah, I was sorry.
Like, Bulletproof, can Bulletproof that joint drop last year? It was raw.
YG's first album?
That's crazy. They only 20. Get Rich or Die Trying was only like, they was three when that shit came out.
Yeah.
We banging that shit.
I play like two songs off of that joint.
Ever.
Wait, nah, what? Not ever. I've listened to the album, but like two songs. Yeah, I play some shit called Something Problems.
Damn, bro. This motherfucker, Irish Witness.
Yo!
Yo, bro, did he?
Something Problems.
That is
all. Alright, so you know what?
Forget about Miniman.
Yeah. Oh, then that's the second one. You feel me?
But then again, like I said, your future job was
alright, so, okay, so one must go. Okay, so,
damn.
How can we format this with five? So two must go if it's five, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, two. Mm-hmm. Alright, so what you said, Victor? So okay, what has to go in my opinion? YNW Melly gotta go.
What?
You gotta keep it. YG gotta go.
If it wasn't for them,
see you made it easy.
I know. Well, he picked Nipsey. It's like Nipsey does have a lot of albums that are great, but Victory was by far it was beautiful.
That was an amazing album.
I don't know. Nipsey Giant, like, I thought.
You have to really listen to his music.
Wait, you damn near disqualified yourself. We said debut album. We said Victory. Like.
That's a debut album. Nipsey has done all his mixtapes. That's a debut.
That's the first studio album.
It is.
First
studio technically.
Album. You found a loophole.
I'll give you that.
Yeesh.
But then, you made it easy.
Yeah,
I feel like YNW Melly's album was better.
But Melly's album.
Have you listened to Reasonable Doubt, bro?
But did you listen
to the original Dead Presidents? Dead Presidents,
hold on, because I know what those
the Evils.
Question him.
Have you listened to Alarm, bro?
Yes. Alarm is fire. City Girls is fire.
City
Girls is awesome.
Yo, you're telling me that's not a summer banger.
You can't.
You're telling me that's not a summer banger.
Y'all gonna tell me.
Yo, wait. So y'all gonna tell me when he was like, yo. PNC Bank. Y'all ain't feel that.
Nah, I know.
Flex, you lost me.
Dear God, I wonder can they save me?
I gotta get y'all on
Illuminati want my mind so in my body.
What's the name of that show? Rate the Bars on BET? I gotta get y'all. Y'all gonna have me going.
Yo.
Oh, you know who?
Little monkey niggas turning gorillas?
Reason.
Come on, man.
There you have it.
Why are you throwing these hoops at them, bro?
Look, we ain't talking YM babe shit, but I'm banging on my ape. I mean, my chest like an ape, bitch.
Nah.
It's the delivery. Yeah. Listen. If I delivered it better, y'all would have been like, oh, shit.
Nah, that still ain't gonna feel.
You know what? I will. Okay, so if YNW, that, it's cliche, but Murder on My Mind and Mind on My Murder go hard.
Bro.
They go hard. That's storytelling 101.
Yo, for real,
they wouldn't be raw.
He did it.
You gotta go. I'm saying, if he didn't sing it like that, deliver it like that.
But he wrote, but like writing that shit too. Cause like, yo, you like he was doing that shit all in like fucking jail, like beating on his chest, writing that shit. And then when he got out, bro was like, he found a producer.
You probably be lying too.
Meanwhile, locked up for double murder.
He's
probably lying.
He's got a personality disorder, so he might be lying. Or that's for court shit. He might be lying.
It might just be for all for publicity.
I respect
you. You think he really did it?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
You guys said
probably,
did it?
Most likely.
Dude, did you see dude on his interview?
Like we actually did an episode on that.
You did?
Long time.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to have to tune into that.
Yeah.
We got real deep in that episode. I forget which week it was, so I can't really plug you on it. But I will say, YNW, had he not got arrested, with the way music is now, especially rap, he would be on that plateau right now.
He would be at the top right now.
Yo, top, bro.
He'd be a freshman. He'd be on the freshman list.
He'd be in a freshman. Yep, I was going to say he would definitely be in there.
Yes. Hell yeah.
What's your favorite song of College Dropout?
Definitely. I like the interludes better than the songs, for real, because it's like, yo, talking about that college shit and like, oh, yeah, you get a college degree. You get a college degree.
D-Ray,
right? I mean, like, yeah.
D-Ray did a lot of shit on that track. And I don't mean that. No, you won't walk across that stage. You won't run across that stage.
Yo, dude, I was walking on campus jamming that shit, and then the skit will come on, bro, and I'll be like, yo, what the fuck am I here?
it definitely puts you in that mind. It definitely gets you there. I get that. But nah, man, see, okay, y'all made it. You made it too easy with this One Must Go. Bro, listen. That was a dub. We need another one. That's okay, so Michael Myers. Michael Myers, Jason, Chucky, and Leatherface.
Oh shit, unanimous?
So
that's a little difficult.
So who gotta go?
Leatherface.
Chainsaw Massacre was great, though.
But it depends.
You know they made two makes of that movie, though.
He was knocking people off, though.
He was knocking
they made a remake
people
of that movie.
Oh,
that's a real
remake.
And it's a true story.
Yeah.
Really took place in Wisconsin.
Right.
Chucky.
Chucky gotta go.
I would give Chucky.
Dude,
so I'm not gonna hold you.
Would we be able to like keep a debut like just like part like the first movie?
Yeah, Michael. We can't get rid of Michael Myers.
Because I'm like, yo, that was like a
we
part.
We can't get rid of Jason.
Nah. Like, I like that because every killer's introduction. Like I think Chucky had the most legendary introduction.
Yeah,
I agree.
When Child's Play first dropped in 88. Okay.
Yep.
When that shit first dropped, in the scene where, because throughout the first 45 minutes of that movie, you didn't see Chucky. You saw him moving in the background, running.
But
the scene where Andy Barclay's mother, she finally confronted the doll or whatever to see if he was alive. She opened up the back, didn't see the batteries there. His head spin around. Hi, I'm Chucky. You want to play? She dropped him under the couch. He rolled under the couch. That was legendary as hell. That's the first time they show an animatronic doll come to life.
Yo. Then that was around the time where it was like peaking market-wise, too.
Fast.
So it was like, yo, people were wilding.
People were able to do more in movie. So to say Chucky gotta go, sick as hell, Jew.
Leather Safe was a big, big motherfucker with it, running with a chainsaw.
He was a dumbass.
He was actually retarded.
Yeah, it was.
Politically incorrect.
He's gonna kill. My brand has been killed before it started.
Violator podcast. Technically,
he was. He was living in. Remember, he was living inside of like the walls of his grandparents or whatever. His family.
Disfigured face. Yeah, he came from a family of cannibals.
Right.
He was all right. Then he gotta go because he'd probably be the last one to get me. I'm out running.
But he got an iconic scene too. The ending of the first Texas Chainsaw Massacre was when the girl got away and he's going crazy, spinning the chainsaw around, losing his mind. That was that's an iconic as hell scene.
That's a fact. That scene is very wild.
You got the pictures from the crime scene.
What did you just say?
I got a picture from the crime scene.
What?
Before my aunt died and passed away, I got the DVD, the pictures from the crime scene. It's in there.
Holy shit.
He's too close to everything going on.
Hey, man, close to it.
I gotta get away.
Eliminating Texas.
I gotta get away.
Was it a documentary or was it actual pictures of the crime scene? Help me out.
Yo, so wait, it was pictures uploaded onto it, like a DVD?
No. There was like, they came in like little separate envelopes, like with a little Texas Chainsaw Massacre sticker. Right?
What did your aunt do?
You do realize.
Was she a detective?
You do realize that it didn't take place in Texas. It took place in Wisconsin.
I know that, but I'm just saying, like, we got.
So why they got a picture? Why they got a Texas emblem?
They just.
Exposure.
Got him.
I gotta see these, bro.
I gotta see them too.
Symbol.
I gotta see them.
Yo, he's about to be looking at him the head is displaced 1 inch.
Hey, listen, violators. We've been talking up. So this Halloween, we was gonna do an episode, and what's it called? Refresh me, James.
I don't know. We're just gonna find a haunted place.
That spot by.
Well, I won't be there, so.
Yes, you will.
I'm a pussy.
What's the, it's by it's kind of downtown, the railroad.
Central Terminal. I'm not going.
They had
the terminal. I was just over there yesterday.
That place isn't even haunted.
It's not. I just did an interview.
I don't play with spirits, bro.
Just did one.
I was with it a couple months ago.
But Annabelle's coming out, and I just don't play with spirits.
Oh, nah.
I wouldn't go there when it's dark.
Nah, bro.
We're going to go there overnight.
On Halloween?
It all depends on what day.
Bring in the Ouija board.
As soon as he said Ouija board, I was out. I heard that.
You would take my spot on that.
No, because I feel like I would play a Ouija board. I would play a Ouija board if people knew how to play it, because I feel like every time I see it go wrong on TV, it's because somebody messed up the rules or didn't close that shit.
You gotta greet the Ouija board, and before you done playing, you gotta say goodbye to the Ouija board.
Right, and I'd be like, motherfuckers never say bye, and then that's how they're all everybody dies and shit.
All I'm saying is,
I'm not opening no lines of communication to no. If you did, I'm not dead.
Yes, he gonna be good.
No, he's not. The white guy goes first.
No, he's a man. Since when is the white guy
going first? I mean, that's your odd
number.
He was without a number.
Scary movie. Scary movies, the black people go first. So token in this one.
I'm
gonna trip you out. In any scary movie you've ever seen, especially when it comes to spirits, is there ever black people in it?
No.
That's a fact.
Because we don't do Ouija board.
That is a really big fact.
We don't do Ouija boards.
We don't do those.
My only thing is,
he's really into this not doing Ouija.
Fuck with me here.
Okay.
My only thing is, if you got all of these crazy deaths that happened in slavery in the South, how come them ghosts ain't coming back fucking them up?
They might be.
I ain't never seen a black ghost.
We don't know what goes on. Bro, I ain't never seen a black ghost. The only black ghost I have ever seen portrayed even is that, you guys seen Big Mouth on Netflix?
Those slave dolls, those were ghosts, black ghosts. Tales from the Hood. So yeah, and it tripped us out when we was kids too.
Yeah. It tripped us. Different though, bro. You can't.
No,
you
it's
can't.
Fine.
They called them the Nigglets.
The Nigglets. Yo, the Nigglets though. That's fire.
All right. So before, because we're gonna close out the episode in a minute, but before I say, we gotta finish off. Okay, so one must go. Michael Myers, Jason, Chucky, Leatherface. We convinced you that Leatherface gotta go. Who gotta go?
Chucky
gotta go.
Just were we able to cut that first? Like, are we able to cut their intro?
Nope, gone from existence.
Oh, shit. He was really killing people. So I don't need to see that on the movie. I can see that on a documentary.
He was
so.
Really killing people. Yeah. I agree with that. Because he was really doing it
without Chuck. Bro, I don't want to see.
They
Chuck.
Never caught him, right?
Who?
Chucky?
Leatherface.
No.
He never got caught. He ate himself alive.
You're lying.
I'm online, bro. I got the Cramsy pictures.
Yo, I can't with you.
Yeah. Right, okay, so who got to go? Michael Myers, Jason, Chucky, Leatherface.
Jason and Mike can't go.
They can't. Yeah. It's unacceptable.
They're the slowest walking fastest
killers fast. In the world.
They LeBron and Jordan.
I'm not going to lie. I'm gonna say Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
I can respect that.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with that too.
I'm
only agreeing because I would rather watch Michael Myers. I would rather watch Jason. I would rather watch Chucky other than watching the massacre all over again.
Because I feel like
I was scared out of my mind. I told you I don't like horror movies.
Yeah, I feel like you'll watch most of the movie with Texas Chainsaw Massacre just going down like a Texas road. Arriving at this one house. Mm-hmm. But it's like, there's like 20 scenes of that shit.
And I wouldn't be caught dead there.
Honestly, two things are
gonna happen. One, you're gonna run into them hillbillies. Two, you're gonna get lynched.
Period. So. Thank you.
So I got more things to worry about.
Exactly. Is brother them gonna get you the clan? One of you.
Yeah, one of them.
How do you wake up and say, I'm gonna probably get eaten alive by a family of cannibals? That's crazy.
Let me just go explore it so I can figure it out.
Who is gonna know that they ate people?
But you know what though? Let's not find out.
Who? I was gonna say who? Awful. Like, will nobody smell that? Will nobody?
Quiet as it's kept.
Did they drink water?
Wait, what? No, quiet as it's kept.
Nah.
It might sound a little sick.
Okay.
But bear with me. I've read stuff on this, and I've seen Motel Hell. The thing is, I've heard that human meat might be the most tastiest, flavorful meat there is on the face of the earth.
Well, I'm not going to Barbados.
Me neither. No, I'm never going to eat it. I'm just saying I've heard that human meat is like the best meat because of the shit we eat, so it's naturally flavored. I'm dead ass.
I never thought about that. Can you imagine though? Like, you have a human who only eats hot fries, right?
Right.
Nah. And then you obviously marked that, and you roast him. Now you got like a hot fries flavored like arm or something.
His arm tastes like pussy.
Thank you. What the hell?
I'm not saying I'm going to, I'm just saying. But okay.
That sounds a little scary. I'm watching you over here.
Nah, Motel Hell, I'm a horror guy. But okay, so
horror.
I'm not a baby.
Okay.
I'ma end the show, I'ma say one gotta go. I'ma say Jason. Jason gotta go.
Are you serious?
I was gonna say, are you just gonna be that guy?
Like,
I'm gonna be that guy, but I'm saying Jason because I own every Friday the 13th movie. I've watched them a couple times. I can never watch another Friday the 13th. It's boring as hell.
The series
is boring.
He killed everybody.
Thank you.
That's a whole.
If you and you did.
Thank you.
It's a whole fact. It's a whole
big fact. Hey, James, actual
if fact. I'm camping, I'm
James. I love
I'm dead.
And
I
you're dead.
I love you, James.
You're dead.
I love you, James, but. White people. He killed white people that were. When am I gonna be in camp for installation?
Get out there on that damn water and shit.
And on that note, violators, this was a good episode. We got Wiz and Flex got on.
Check out his album. Plug it up.
Yes.
Plug yourself.
Oh shit, yeah, it's on everywhere. Tidal, Apple Music.
Spotify, anywhere that you stream music, FLXGDD, and the album's called Heaven. I really hope you like it.
Flex God, tune in.
Yes.
Wiz, you got something dropping in November, you said?
Yeah, of course, I have my mixtape.
Okay.
But that's for details later.
All right, we'll bring you back later.
Like I said,
I do not have a title of my tape yet.
Got everybody back on.
Yep.
All right, once again, I'm Super Saiyan Jaffe.
Cool Guy JD.
Seymour Kate.
Flex God.
Wiz Inks.
He got Jimmy Thump in the background. He ain't gonna say nothing. He left Shaq. Right. Oh, yeah, I guess so.
He's prepared.
And we violators. We out.